We've spent our time so far learning about our car and our drive circuit and testing individual components. Now it's time to start connecting everything together and see if it all works.
We're going to need to make some cables for this.
We have our crimping tool we're going to use to put the terminals on our high voltage cable. But I haven't used this yet. My understanding is you have this lug here, put on the end of the cable, then you put it in here.
Just put your finger right in there.
You align this and hit it with a sledgehammer.
Come over to the crimping bench. We just put the wire into the lug. Beautiful crimped connector.
We've made our first cable.
In the process of crimping this, I seem to have bent this part here up at the top. And now I gotta unbend it because it's not coming open again.
More cables!
We needed to test the BMS's temperature sensor because lithium iron phosphate batteries won't charge below 0 degrees Celsius. And it's not just that they won't charge when it's that cold, it's that if you try, you'll ruin them. Since some reviewers have had problems with daily temperature sensors, we needed to see if ours worked.
We are gonna label our batteries.
Battery 19 has a sympathy frowny face on it.
Get well soon.
There's probably a better way to do this. Labeling this 1.5 makes sense to me.
It's probably a better way to do everything we do.
Case in point, I pulled the sticker off before writing on it, so now I have to do something like this. We're labeling the cables so that we can... this is actually wrong. This is great that we started recording for this one. This is actually this cable, not this cable. So fuck that.
Good job.
We're labeling them so that when we disconnect them, we hook them back up to the correct batteries. We called this 2.5, even though that doesn't make sense. How can you have half of a cable? But it's just to tell us it's between batteries 2 and 3.
The temperature is 15 degrees Celsius.
That's right. Little wire. Yeah.
Oh, you can just like hold it between your fingers.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Put it under my tongue.
It's getting warmer.
So it's definitely not fake.
You don't want to know where they put the probe in the factory when they're testing them.
The A in QA stands for this. Quality anus. Gosh, I hope that's waterproof.
Oh, we're at 1 degree Celsius.
Yep.
That turned off. That was on.
Oh, before. Cool.
So...
Oh, good. So
it knows it shouldn't charge right now.
Time to build a pre-charge circuit. So we've got a contactor, a big fuse, a resistor, and a pre-charge relay.
This is the resistor we're going to be using.
A Dale.
Yep. Relay works kind of like a contactor. You apply power to two terminals, and then it makes a connection between two other terminals that's normally not there. For a pre-charge circuit, we wire up the end that goes to the battery on one end, and then to the controller on the other end, and until we energize this relay, we don't have a connection.
A little snag, it won't go in.
This drill is from 70 years ago, which as we all know is 1930.
They used to use this drill to build B-17s back in the war.
Oh my god! Do you have a smaller drill?
Hand protecting my crotch.
We've got the meter hooked up. Right now it's saying one, which means there's no continuity, which is what we would expect because this isn't energized yet. I have the power supply hooked up to these other two terminals. When I turn on the power supply, there's a click from the relay. Now we have continuity between these two.
We're soldering again. Now are these wires even going to be able to handle the amount of current that's going to end up going through them?
It's actually going to be a pretty low current for the pre-charge. We're basically just trickling a little bit of power into the controller to avoid inrush current on the capacitors. All these are capacitors. Whenever we apply power, you don't want to just go full into high voltage. You want to have the pre-charge to avoid inrush current that would damage these capacitors.
Damage the capacitors and also fuse the contactor shut. Working on wiring up our pedal again, making a few wires to connect it to the controller.
Now for the pièce de résistance. If we hook up our batteries, BMS, pre-charge relay, controller, potentiometer pedal, and motor, will they all work together? Or will something catch on fire?
So our pre-charge circuit's wired up. We're gonna get ready to test the pre-charge and the contactor.
Contactor, but the cord said I couldn't do that anymore.
We need to turn this on first to pre-charge the controller, and then we turn this off when we actually want to run the controller. Got our power supply, got a switch, check, make sure. I go from here to here. There shouldn't be any continuity between here and here until I turn this power supply on. Now we should have continuity from here to here, and we do.
Reconnecting our batteries and the BMS cables again. But at least we haven't labeled this time, so it'll be a little bit quicker.
Thanks to whoever manufactured our batteries, because this hole is actually smaller than all the rest.
The BMS negative is going to go to the total negative of the battery bank. Total positive off the battery bank is going to go through this massive fuse into our controller. And then our pre-charge circuit is going to come off of here, bypass this contactor, and then come back in on this connector here. Total battery positive, that's going
to
go
goes to the pre-charge circuit and the fuse and the contactor.
The other reason why we needed the drill today, this is the controller negative connector. Here's the bolts we were using before. Not enough to put a nut on there, let alone another connector. Larger bolts that I got doesn't fit in there. Dave happened to have a wood screw.
Isn't that going to burn the fucking wood?
No. If this gets hot enough to start a wood fire, then we have bigger problems.
Yeah, we're going to replace that ASAP. There won't be a block of wood being used as a spacer after today.
Ignore that.
Nothing to see here.
The gap between the contacts on the controller seemed narrower than we would like, so to prevent a short circuit, we got out our trusty hacksaw.
We believe we have everything hooked up here. Starting there from a total positive, coming here to our fuse. Pre-charge circuit is over there, hooked up to the contactor, the controller, out to the motor, and back to here.
I've got a condom.
Then to our BMS, which is then connected to our total negative. The only thing we haven't worked into it so far is the SEPEX. BMS is alive again.
Number 19 is still lower than it should be. So we have our BMS plugged in. I have it connected to my phone now. We have it hooked up to this fuse. The contactor is what supplies the high voltage to the controller and ultimately the motor. We can't turn that on yet. We need a pre-charge. That's what these two wires are here. We need a pre-charge through here, then turn this circuit off, and then energize the contactor, which should energize the controller. So we're getting 86 volts, so it's probably pre-charged.
Let me drain, probably. Yep.
Yeah, okay, let me read the documentation, because that LED does mean something. LED on when? At start, the controller blinks 2 times. There's other conditions. Current limit is active, which we know we don't have yet. That's if you're maxing out the controller. Enable input is open, which I need to revisit that now I think about it. Under and over voltage protection, over temperature protection, and then while UART communication, which we don't have hooked up. Enable input. I just remembered that there are 2 connectors here that we need to bridge. We need to make a short little wire.
It's weird to bridge 2 of them.
Well, it's so that you can have a switch to turn the whole thing on and off.
There we go.
Ultimately, we will have a switch. But now we power this on again. Let's watch for it to blink twice.
Yep.
Dave's backing.
I'll stay here.
I'm making room for the cameraman.
Yeah. I walked away earlier because Jason was drilling something, and if he lost control of it, it would have flung around and hit me in the nuts.
Contactor makes a funny noise if you don't have the voltage up enough. It's normal. I've done this before.
Okay. There we go.
Saw a couple blinks on the LED.
That's there we go. What you want.
And oh my god! Holy shit! This is so fucking cool!
That worked.
It's working! It's working!
Not the way we wanted it to.
It didn't?
It shouldn't have done any motion.
Oh, you're right.
Because the pedals. Pedal for that reason.
Yeah, that's okay though.
Well, let's see what happens when I depress the pedal. See if.
Okay.
Okay. It's spinning up slowly. That's me pushing the pedal.
Right,
oh,
shit, turn it off. So, it doesn't decelerate.
So, it's not just in the car right
now. Absolutely.
So, what's going on here? Let's figure it out.
So, we probably need to program this controller.
Yeah, okay. But
this is our first full system test, and it worked.
Almost full. We haven't done the setbacks.
No setbacks. That's okay. So this is our what is it, series wound test?
Yep.
So to recap, we can accelerate, we cannot stop, but that's fine.
And we're getting acceleration even when we don't command it, which is a little concerning.
Yeah, we're getting some kind of movement, which we would prefer not to. The optimist take on what just happened is that nothing caught on fire, we didn't short anything, and nobody's dead. Can't ask for more than that, really.
So our next step is to program our controller so that it understands our pedal's input better. After that, we will work on incorporating the motor's step-x field into the circuit. The whole it can accelerate but not decelerate problem reminds me of this wiring diagram we saw on the internet at some point that said do not reverse, meaning the polarity, but it could also be interpreted to mean that you won't be able to use the motor to parallel park. Show your support for mini trucks with a sticker from our store. We also have a GoFundMe. The links are in the description. Next video will either be an update about our progress on the wall charger and batteries or about programming the controller. Don't miss it, because it won't suck.